Fiji, bro.
No way.
No way.
What you doing, Loz?
Ah, how you going, man? Yeah, no, we're just putting a putting a bit of a guard here for the reefing point on this Jack George. When they come down here and we're reefed in heavy weather, it's tearing the bag out of the wood. They've got a hell of a lot of rigging coming up in the near future. All these rigging, all these stays have got to be replaced. Hell of a lot of work to do. Jesus, nice to be blue water again, isn't it? Look at that. 160 degrees, you can't see a damn thing. 800 miles behind us, we've got Australia. 50 miles ahead of us, we've got Norfolk Island.
Where the folks, they all leave in New Orleans. The land of dreams, by the
that saxophone guy, you ever hear anything like that, man? Bop, bop, bop. Woo! Yeah, man! Good old bass and street blues. Hey, guess what?
What?
We got some weather coming in, I think.
Yep.
Yeah, it's definitely coming in.
So, I reckon the second the dark, just before the dark, gets strong the main, get rid of it.
Yeah, we'll get rid of the main. Definitely, yeah. Norfolk Island, first foreign landfall, even though it's Australian territory, it's the first foreign landfall for a lander for like, seven years. 7 year itch. Jesus, nice to be offshore again. We'll be doing a rum line from here to Fiji. We're expecting a good southwesterly to come through in a day or so, 24 hours. So for the next day, we're going to lap up Norfolk Island, a place I've never seen before, neither has anyone on the crew seen it before, neither has Atlanta ever landed here before. So, let's see what it brings, eh? We might even take the camera ashore.
On the southern side of the island lies the ruins of the old penal settlement, where countless convicts spent their final days. Norfolk Island Penal Colony was designed as a place of the severest punishment short of death. It was understood that anyone sent there had no hope of return.
You will find we need nothing more.
Interned in a cell no more than 4 paces in length, while chained to a ring bolt on the wall, being sentenced to death, was the only way to escape the suffering.
Find us with the cares.
Punishment could be up to 300 lashes with a cat and nine tails. In some cases, the white bones of their backs would be exposed through what was left of their flesh. Punishment would be administrated for any of the following reasons: for having a pipe, for not walking fast enough, for not pushing hard enough on the stone cart, for having tobacco in your possession, for asking a jailer for tobacco, for smiling when on the chain, for asking a jailer a question, or for singing a song.
This bridge is called Bloody Bridge, reason being that the supervisor was slain by two of the builders who were convicts, and they hit him in the dug him into the cement and rock work. But anyway, a day or so later, the blood started to ooze out of the brickwork, calling it Bloody Bridge. The convicts were caught and hung and buried over there in the yard.
With the cares of the world far behind us, yes, we have all the time in the world just for love, nothing more.
In 1834, there was a mutiny on this island, Norfolk Island, where the convicts overthrew the existing government, or the drivers, slave drivers, whatever you want to call them, screws or whatever. And this is what's left of those mutineers, this little row of gravestones along here. And if you take a focus in on that, you can see there's a skull and crossbones.
Some of the convicts revolted against the ruling establishment, resulting in many executions, and any attempt to escape seemed futile, as the nearest land was over 400 miles away. But only one lucky soul managed to succeed. The graveyard is a standing monument to these cruel colonial times.
Now when the saints marching in, when the saints go marching in, yes, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in, now when the saints go marching by, yeah, I would like to hit the numbers. Jacob like Edmund Hall with his parents, now be one out of the moment. Lord, I want to be in that number. Here comes Trumpet Young and his trombone wailing.
Say farewell to Norfolk Island. It's been a beautiful 2 days here with our friends Dean and Helen, and here we are off back on the road again, heading for Fiji, which is laying about 1,000 nautical miles that way.
We might get a ride.
Oh, yeah. Let's try this one.
Yes!
Not quite.
Whoa! Billy! Don't you break nothing, Mr. Piper. We've just spent 4 days fixing things.
Fiji, got a bit of a gale on here today. The land is really lapping up. We got about a 30 knot breeze with Storm Reef. I'm loving every minute of it. Woo!
Oh, the shark has pretty deep, dear, and he shows them pearly whites. Just a jackknife as mag heap, dear, and he keeps it out of sight. When the shark bites with his teeth, dear, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy
still and his master.
Where's McHeap, dear? So there's not a trace of red. Oh, on the sidewalk Sunday morning lies a body oozing life. Someone sneaking round the corner. Is that someone back the knife? Yes, from a tugboat by the river, baby. A cement bag drooping down, and the cement.
How you doing? Well, here we are. We've just had 3 days of flat calm, not a breath of wind. Been wallowing around with nothing, sailing a little bit at night with light airs. This morning, the wind sprung up. We've only got about 30 miles to go to Fiji. We can see the island. It's over that way. After, what has it been, about 16, 17 days at sea. It's been a beautiful crossing. We've had a variety of weather. We've had north, south, east and west. A southwesterly gale that pumped us along. We cracked on almost 15 knots there for a little while. It's been one of the nicest little voyages I've had in a long time. Looking forward to Fiji tomorrow. We'll probably be going into the marina at Latoka, or anchoring around Latoka sometime tomorrow afternoon.
Jenny Diver. Lottie Lynn, yes, sweet Lucy Brown, yes, the line farms on the right, dear. Now that my kid's back in town.